In the name of Allah, the most merciful and the entirely merciful. All praise is due to Allah the Almighty, the Lord of the world. May Allah's peace, mercy, and blessings be upon His final and last messenger, Muhammad. And may Allah's peace, mercy, and blessings be with each and every one of you, dear viewers, watching this new episode of our program, The Revelation, here on LTV International. In this episode, my dear viewers, we will be picking up where we left in the previous episodes, highlighting the position of the Islamic jurisprudence when it comes to peaceful coexistence. We will be picking up where we left, highlighting a very important principle of Islam with regards to peaceful coexistence, and that's how is it Islam lays the foundations for building bridges for peaceful coexistence to be a sustainable, effective, and durable one. Definitely, my dear viewers, there is more to be highlighted and shared with you in light of this very noble divine verse of the noble Quran.
يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم إن الله عليم خبير.
In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate, O mankind, indeed, we have created you from male and female and made you peoples and tribes that you may know one another. Indeed, the most noble of you in the sight of Allah is the most righteous of you. Indeed, Allah is knowing and aware.
Clearly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is again urging us to be humbled and be modest, as we are reminded by the fact that we are created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we all as human beings have the same origin. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلٍ, in order to tell us that it is the divine will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has decreed for us to be created and fashioned various, several, and plural in our way, in our objectives, in our pursuits. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we have created you into various or several or pluralistic shu'uban, peoples, wa qaba'il, tribes, in order to highlight this fact that yes, maybe we have different ethnicities, but still, this is out of the divine wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed. Thus, we need to be humbled by this fact, and not for one of us to feel superior or to feel better than the other, because it is not our choice. Rather, it is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
The plants and trees, he created the birds and bees, he created the oceans and seas, some of his many bounties.
And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides us out of His mercy and out of His wisdom to the rationale, or the wisdom, if you like, behind this diversity and the creation. And that's لِتَعَارَفُ, and you understand in the Arabic language, li or a lamb here, this is called the lamb that shows the reason. The lamb that shows, in the linguistic sense, the justification or the motive. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, of course, not in need of providing a justification or providing a reason, but it is out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order to enlighten our understanding and to provide us with deeper knowledge as to our own very existence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِتَعَرَفُوا, so that you may get to know one another. And here we really need to pause and to think and to reflect that the reason behind this diversity and this variation is not to think that one race or skin color is superior to another, or another one is inferior to a third one. Rather, the aim here is to get to know one another. So it's not to fight one another. It's not to shame one another. It's not to target one another. It's not to judge one another. Rather, it is to embrace one another, to accept one another, and to get to know one another. Because we understand, how is it getting to know one another? This is the basis and the foundation for building peace, for mutual respect, and for mutual understanding.
يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ.
In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate, O mankind, indeed, we have created you from male and female and made you peoples and tribes that you may know one another. Indeed, the most noble of you in the sight of Allah is the most righteous of you. Indeed, Allah is knowing and aware.
All these negative phenomena that we witness in some societies when it comes to racial discrimination or other negative, unhealthy, deplorable, and totally unacceptable phenomena that exist in some societies. As a matter of fact, when we look deeply and analyze them, they happen to be the result of ignorance. And this is why here the Quran is providing the cure for this unhealthy phenomenon and similar ones, and that's by telling us the reason for our own existence is to get to know one another. And attaining this proper knowledge about one another is the cure, is the ultimate resort for us to avoid any forms of misunderstanding, any forms of negative stereotypes, any form of discrimination. So here we are encouraged through the divine guidance of the Noble Quran to get to know one another. And in this process still, and as we are observing this divine task or instruction to get to know one another, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still reminds us of a very important fact to keep in mind, and that's إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. For indeed, the most honorable of you and the most valuable of you and the highest of you in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is the most conscious, mindful, and observing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Ya ayyuhan nas inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu inna akramakum 'indallahi atqakum innallaha 'alimun khabir.
In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate. O mankind, indeed we have created you from male and female and made you peoples and tribes that you may know one another. Indeed, the most noble of you in the sight of Allah is the most righteous of you. Indeed, Allah is knowing and aware.
This is very important because even in the process of getting to know one another, there still can be some debris of superiority or discrimination. Yet, still as this process of getting to know one another is happening, a very important foundation and very basic principle to keep in mind is the fact that the most honorable of us in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is the most cautious and mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we treat others, we deal them as manifestations of the ultimate power and existence and might of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Ya ayyuhan nas inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu inna akramakum 'indallahi atqakum innallaha 'alimun khabir.
In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate. O mankind, indeed, we have created you from male and female and made you peoples and tribes that you may know one another. Indeed, the most noble of you in the sight of Allah is the most righteous of you. Indeed, Allah is knowing and aware.
Definitely, my dear viewers, there is more to be highlighted and shared with you in light of this very noble divine verse of the Noble Quran, but this brings us to the end of this episode. So inshallah, in the upcoming ones, we will be picking up where we left, highlighting a very important principle of Islam with regards to peaceful coexistence, and that's how is it Islam lays the foundations for building bridges for peaceful coexistence to be a sustainable, effective and durable one. As always, your questions, feedback and comments are most welcome via the official Facebook page of the program and the rest of the social media. Until then, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.